Tonight, with little for the U.S. to celebrate as Russia tightens its death grip in Mariupol, the Biden administration is touting one notable triumph, the seizure of yet another luxury yacht, this one valued apparently at $300 million, owned by a sanctioned Russian oligarch. Authorities in Fiji served a U.S. search warrant after the yacht was found docked there. The U.S. believes it was headed for Russia to avoid exactly what happened today. The White House took a victory lap of sorts in the briefing room this afternoon as it celebrated the takedown. Our Kara Scannell has more on the latest seizure and gives us an inside look at the American mission to go after Vladimir Putin's assets and his wealthiest friends. Kara, so what about this boat?
Yeah, so this yacht was seized on Thursday in Fiji by the local authorities at the request of the U.S. Now, they say that this yacht was tied to a Russian oligarch who made his fortune in gold. They say that he violated numerous laws in the U.S., and that's why they asked the Fiji government to seize it. Now, this yacht, which is about 350 feet long with a lot of luxury details on it, will then sail back to the U.S. and dock at an undisclosed port. From there, the U.S. Department of Justice will foot the bill to maintain the yacht and pay the crew so that it doesn't diminish in value, and that they ultimately hope to sell it off for a profit. And some of that money, if Congress passes the Biden administration's bill, could go back to Ukraine. Anderson?
You also got the chance to speak with the head of the Justice Department unit who's tracing oligarch assets. How is that search going?
Well, as you said, this is the second yacht that they've seized in the 2 months of operation. And I sat down with the head of the Justice Department's Klepto Capture Task Force, Andrew Adams. He says that they are casting a wide net, and the number one on their list are all of these oligarchs and Russian government officials who are on the U.S. sanctions list. Here's what he said. So anyone who is on the sanctions list is potentially a target.
That's right. And to be even more specific, anyone who's on the sanctions list is not only a target for sanctions evasion, but we are looking at this in a holistic manner. If you are a listed oligarch, if you are a sanctioned entity, our interest is in any charge to hand. So if we're talking about sanctions evasion, that's great. If we're talking about money laundering, that'll be brought. But if we're talking about visa fraud, if we're talking about bank fraud, if we're talking about COVID fraud, we'll bring any charge to hand to disrupt and discomfort the people who are on that list.
And the biggest name on that list is Vladimir Putin. What can you tell us that the U.S. knows about his wealth and where his assets are?
I can tell you nothing about what the U.S. knows about any particular person, but he's certainly on the list, as are, I think importantly, beyond very wealthy, very famous sort of celebrity oligarchs. There are people who are close to the Kremlin, who are in the Kremlin, people who have a role and have a voice within the Russian defense industry, the Russian defense ministry.
Now, Adams says that they are also looking at some other assets, including luxury apartments in New York City and in Miami. He also said that they are looking to enforce other laws that would block Russia from importing sensitive technologies, particularly for the military. Anderson?
Kara Scannell, appreciate it. Thanks.